All right, first of all, I'd like to thank everyone for coming. I'm not going to focus on the fact that you're 22 minutes late. What I'm going to say to you is that I am grateful that you have shown up today. We're a little concerned about the housekeeping practices on this job site. It's kind of a mess around here. There's tools everywhere. There's debris, nails. Things need to be picked up. Now, we don't expect a lot from you folks because we've seen your trucks. The interior cabs of some of your vehicles look like landfills. There's seagulls pecking at the windows trying to get at the turkey bones. Look, good housekeeping isn't just about cleanliness, it's about safety. We need you to report and clean up any spills or leaks around this job site. We need you to know your hazards. Is that just spilled water, or is that the sweat from the brow of a plumber that just got schooled by Rocco for leaving empty cans of PVC glue everywhere? I don't know, but let's clean it up. We need you to follow spill response procedures. That means being familiar with any chemicals that are on this construction site, including fuels or liquids or adhesives. If a spill happens, tell everybody. Hashtag spills happen. And I'm not talking about texting a scary emoji of a skull and crossbones or a burning 55-gallon drum. Hashtag run for your life. I'm talking about talking to everybody on the site. Hashtag fire in the hole. If you're gonna oil your beard on the job, use a drip pan. We are trying to prevent any type of slipping accidents. So if you're applying sunscreen or body butter or hand moisturizer, make sure it doesn't land on the ground. If you spill some of your grape vape juice because you're trying to load up your e-cig, but you can't stop your hand from shaking from all the tequila you had last night, make sure you don't do it over an area where someone could slip. Make sure to clean up any dirt or dust that accumulates on floors or decks or on any safety programs that haven't been opened in a while. Also, make sure exit routes are clearly marked, indicating the direction of travel. No arrows should be pointing up unless you're actually trying to climb the stairway to heaven. All lighting should be in good working order. Any exits or stairways or walkways should be sufficiently lit. If you enter a confined space, bring a portable light or a flashlight. You should never hear anybody say, "Hey man, does that smell like gas?"
"I don't know, man. I can't see nothing."
"Well, hang on. I think I got a lighter." Be good housekeepers. We're not asking the world from you. We just want you to stay safe. We know your limitations. If Rocco drops anything, any type of DNA, nail clippings, pieces of his hair, use Kleenexes. We're not saying touch that. We'll call a biohazard crew for that.